If you struggle with ADHD, then I don't have to tell you that it can be overwhelming and it can make it so feeling motivated to get the things done that you need to get done leads to procrastination and time spent not achieving the goals that you set out to in the morning. I'm Dr. Trish Leigh, and I have worked with thousands of people who struggle with ADHD. My goal is to help you understand that there's more ways to treat ADHD that you might not be aware of. And I don't want you to neglect the idea that there's alternative treatments that actually work to get to the root of ADHD and to give you a solution that not only works in the short run, but can help you over time. So in this video, I want you to understand that thinking that medication is the only solution is neglectful to the vaster understanding of ADHD as a neurodevelopmental disorder. And I don't want you to miss the idea that a neurodevelopmental disorder can be treated and healed using neuroscience. So there is technology that exists that can not only assess how your brain is performing and show you definitively in a visual representation of a qEEG brain map that yes, in fact, indeed, your brain is using the ADHD brain pattern. Once you see that with your own eyes, what it does is it allows you to see what is at the core of your ADHD and what needs to happen to be able to shift it and heal it long term so you don't struggle with those symptoms anymore. So we know from science that at the root of ADHD is something that's called a theta to beta ratio. Theta is slow speed in the brain. Beta is faster processing speed in the brain. So essentially, if you struggle with ADHD, your brain is using too much slowing, too much theta. Too much slow processing speed in the brain makes it so that it's difficult to focus, it's difficult to attend, it's difficult to use executive function skills, putting smaller pieces together for a larger picture. It's difficult to control impulses. It leads to procrastination and it makes it so you're not getting done the things that you want to get done. It's because of excessive theta. At the same time, you may have low use of beta, that faster processing speed. Beta is the speed that helps you to focus. It helps you to stay on task. It helps you to stay motivated. So essentially, if your theta to beta ratio is too big, the gap between slow and fast, if it is too large, it'll be difficult to do all of the things that I just mentioned. At the core of ADHD is a theta to beta ratio that is too big. I consider it the healing gap for ADHD. The bigger the gap between theta and beta, as we close that gap, your brain heals and you'll no longer struggle with ADHD symptoms. You know how I know? Because I've helped hundreds of people to be able to do that in my professional neurofeedback program. Now, the best part about that program is just like the brain map, it's all measurable. You will never be taking my word for it. You will see how your brain is performing every single day, and you will see that theta to beta ratio gap close and stay closed forever. I know what you're thinking. No way that can possibly happen. I'm here to tell you, yes, it can. So the way that that works is there is a progress visualization graph over time. And when I work with people, we have our eye on this graph the entire duration of the program, Professional Neurofeedback with me. And I can see the gap closing in real time. You always know how far away you are from closing that gap all the way. So for some people, it takes just a few months. That's why my program's 4 months long. For other people, it does take longer, but you always know how far away and how fast the gap is closing. It becomes so motivating because you feel yourself being able to think and perform better while you see the gap closing. So I don't want you to think there's no way you can tell if you have ADHD, and to the extent that you can. You can. You can see ADHD in your brain on a qEEG brain map, and you can see how extensive that ADHD is. The way that it works is I'm able to assess the areas of your brain and the magnitude of the theta to beta ratio in each of them. So obviously, the more areas that are involved and the greater that healing gap, the theta to beta ratio, the more you have ADHD in your brain. Then we close those gaps, the less you have ADHD in your brain and in your life. So if you're interested in help that thinks outside of the box of medication, I want you to know it's available. Please go over to drtrishleigh.com and check out the qEEG brain map. I would love to help you get to that point of focused motivation on purpose so you can rock out the rest of your life. I hope to see you over there. And until next time, control your brain or it'll control you.